गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, आई एम साक्षी अग्रवाल, एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर ऑफ द सेज ग्रुप. द सेज ग्रुप इज डाइवर्सिफाइड इनटू रियल एस्टेट, एजुकेशन, पावर एंड इलेक्ट्रिकल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. वी बेसिकली हैव इन एजुकेशन, वी आर इन दिस इंडस्ट्री सिंस 2003. वी हैव थ्री इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेजेस एंड वी हैव थ्री MBA कॉलेजेस, two pharmacy colleges. We provide MCA, diploma. Also, we have two schools known as Sage International Schools, and we have two universities, Sage University Indore and Sage University Bhopal. The Indore University was established in 2017, and in 2020, Sage University Bhopal is also established. I get the privilege of being a part of this Sage group. I have done my BBA from Narsimunji, Bombay, and then I went to Singapore Management University for my master's. I find it a real privilege to be part of this group, because it is, I have been a part of this group since birth, you can say, because my father started it, and I have seen the growth and the potential and the sweats and the midnight oil that was born to make this company what it is today. We are connected to we have 18,000 students studying with the Sage group currently, and have 50,000 alumni, plus we have various tie-ups and opportunities provided to students for their placements. In all, the Sage group touches 4 lakh lives, have touched 4 lakh lives till now. So being the executive director, having this responsibility to serve society, which is basically our tagline also, bringing happiness to society. So this is my introduction, and I just want to thank everyone, a part of Sage group, and all the people who have given so much love to this group. Thank you.
That's great. So just, you know, Sakshi, I'll start off with the first question for the interview. And that is, you know, you became the executive director of Sage University at a very young age, you know. So what is your philosophy of leadership, and, you know, how would you describe your leadership style?
Right. So I just turned 24 like 3 days back, and a lot of people, you know, get astonished when they see such a young girl being handling such a huge number of people and driving in positive output and results for the organization. So for me, leadership does not come with age. It really comes with the experience that a person has. Now, one can argue that the experience also comes with age. But for me, the positive is that I am getting the experience of my age, plus I am getting the experience directly of my father's age, because he is teaching me each day about how to deal with people, how to manage money, how to manage human resources. So for me, I take it in a very positive note that I, at such a young age, I'm getting such a great opportunity to interact with such great leaders. I deeply respect all the members of Sage Group who are guiding me, who are motivating me, are my mentors, and that involves the Pro Chancellor of Sage University, Dr. Prashant Jain, and for our real estate wing, Rupesh Ghorke sir, and for our power wing, Anupam Pandit sir. So these thought leaders are with me as my guiding force to take Sage to newer heights. So what kind of leader I am? I think I have a dominant personality, and I tend to be very observant. I like, people say this about me, which I've heard in many speeches, that I'm a very sharp learner, like I'm a very sharp observer also. So I really go into the integrity of a proposal or of a particular analysis that has come to me, and I try to make making tangible output so that they can be measured. And also, I think that for a leader, it is very important to take quick decisions also, but with proper thought given to them. So for me, I'm still learning that, and I am a quick learner, but I need to be more thoughtful before I make a decision, because though if my 90% of the decisions are right, those 10% decisions that I take in a very quick manner can also be improved. So this is a journey, and I am just thankful that I have learned a lot, but it has the beginning. This is the beginning, right? The journey has just started. So it will take a long way. I can't wait to see after 30 years what I will be, right? If I am this right now, I am so proud of course, myself also. I can give myself some credit, because it was not easy. People might think sometimes that it's easier when you are the boss's child or the leader's child, you know, joining a family business. But truly, I would like to tell everyone, it's much harder than it looks. Because my family is a little, conservative and very, very disciplined family, I can say. So I have to be like that and just try to make right decisions in coordination with every stakeholder which is involved in the decision.
That's a really great insight from the end on, you know, the journey of Sage. And I hope that you take Sage University to greater heights under the guidance of your father and other leaders that you have mentioned. And, you know, I hope that you achieve a lot more in life and make a name for yourself. On that note, I'd like to move on to our next question, which is, you know, one of the major aspects of any university to succeed is a well-designed curriculum, you know, and be in sync with current times. So how does the curriculum of Sage University ensure that the best practices of industry are followed and the students learn the maximum while at the university?
I'm very glad that I'm asked this question. When I was a student, I witnessed that all the trainings and all the theory that was being taught to me was, as I said, very theoretical. All right, if someone is teaching me human resources, I need to manage some human resources to actually understand. So I truly believe that theoretical knowledge is just half a cup, and maybe not even half a cup. You know, you cannot learn how to swim by knowing the steps on how to swim. So I believe that practical learning with theoretical knowledge will lead to a greater self-fulfillment in career and personal life. And that's what we do in the curriculum of Sage University, Indore and Bhopal. We provide practical learning in collaboration with your classes. That's why in a lot of our courses, we have tied up with industry partners. Because what we had seen in the past, that when a particular student gets placed in a particular company, that company trains that student for, you know, a year or 2 years and then gives them full-time job. Whereas we went to them and said that why not you train them here only, right? We can create a curriculum in a way there our syllabus is also completed, plus your practical learning is also given, which is correlated to the syllabus. So when the student involves and indulges in a 4-year intensive course or a 3-year intensive course, the final product should be not again to put it into training, but to now receive output from that learning. So the curriculum of Sage University is practical based learning. Thank you.
I would definitely agree that, you know, currently major, you know, complaints or the concerns of the industry leaders are also that the students coming from colleges are not so well trained in practical knowledge, and they do not have a very good idea about what is actually happening in the industry. It's great to know that, you know, Sage University actually emphasizes on it and makes better students and obviously people who are ready to enter the industry and rock it, to be very frank. Yeah. On that note, let's move on to our next question. You know, you are a very young leader, and with that comes a lot of responsibility also. That, you know, what do you think are your roles and responsibility to the university and students are?
Right. So, Nishita, as I was telling you, I lived I was on my own for 4 years. After school, I was in Bombay for 3 years and 1 year in Singapore. So these 4 years, I had a very independent approach to learning and to think. So after coming back, when I saw what my father puts in to the work of Sage Group, how many hours he puts and his vision, when I learned that whatever he does, he doesn't have to do it, you know, for his personal fulfillment. He does it because he thinks that God has given him the capability to make lives better of the people around him, of the society that has served him so well over the years. So my whole criteria now is that I know there will be future generations and I know what the current world is lacking. So the whole aim, I think my role and my responsibility is that the future generations should see a better world when we are gone, right? That's the least that we can do for them. And this involves all our children, all the current parents and the society members. And this is my role to the Sage Group also, because I have for 2,500 people being involved with me directly. So all those lives are dependent on the decisions taken by Sage Group. So that's a huge responsibility, and I humbly accept all of those responsibilities because I must have done something in my previous life that I was given this beautiful, beautiful opportunity to affect so many lives. And I just hope that I remain true to it and I can do justice to the people around me and to the society and the students and the thousands of people who buy homes from me. And that is what my role and responsibility is. There's a Spider-Man quote. Movie Spider-Man: with great power comes great responsibility. And that's the motto, right? Like, I have great power, but with that I have a great responsibility too.
I so relate with you. You know that I'm pretty sure the aspiring students of Sage University also would relate with what you're saying. And you know, they would relate. It's great to know that you have done so much at such a young age, and you know, you do have a very great responsibility, and I would agree to that. On that note, let's move on to our next question. You know, the industry is growing at a very fast pace. So what do you think should be Sage University's top priority over 10 years so that it remains relevant and at par with its peer universities?
Right. So when we talk about the next 10 years of the education industry, I would want to see at where the industries are. As I have told that we have tied up with industries and we are in direct contact with them to any new changes that are brought according to the changes brought into the industry. Our curriculum also changes. So like, you know, we do modifications in it likewise, so that the people, the students are updated in the technology. We're not teaching them the same thing that is not like relevant today. So that's the vision for the 10 years, that we remain industry updated, plus at the same time fulfill our responsibility to the society, that we will create a more responsible, independent student who can do what he loves to do and be happy in it. So I think the sole purpose of any university should be that. And when I say this, I don't want to be ahead of other universities, because that is not for me to be like have a target of. I want to have a target of my students going into the market and not begging for jobs. My vision is that when they go outside in the market, they should get the job that they want because of their talent, and they can be happy about it. They should be happy in what they're doing because they have to spend 8 to 9 hours each day to do that. So that is the vision for the 10 years coming 10 years. Thank you.
That's really great. Job is definitely an output that students look forward to, that they get well placed in good companies, and you know, they have jobs, responsibilities, and companies that are that match their caliber. So definitely that should be the priority of most of the university, and that is in sync with many people that I've spoken to also, that they want to, you know, churn out students who are you know, job ready, industry ready, and give out an output which is at par and what industry requires at this point of time. And you know, on that note, let's move on to our next question, which is, you know, what do you see is Sage University's greatest strength, which makes it what it is today?
So when I talk about Sage University greatest strength, when you said these four words, the thing that came into my mind is what our chancellor and my father believes in and motivates everyone to have is live with purity, you know. And we believe that to be happy, you have to live in Sat Chit Anand always. That slogan he says in every meeting he takes. Sat Chit Anand means that with true honesty, you have to be happy from within. Right, so you're always happy, you are in Sat Chit Anand always. So the whole value, core value of, and the greatest strength that it converts to is the purity in each and every being in the group and people associated with it, that we always believe even if someone is not thinking good for you, you can change that thinking by being positive yourself. Once you are positive yourself, your vibes really change the person. It might take a day, two, few months, but if you do not let those negative feelings enter yourself, you remain pure. The person in front of you will have a drastic change in his or her approach, and that's what I want to live by. This is the philosophy that my father believes in, and that's why the whole group, if I talk about Sage, we talk about Sage International Schools or SIRT colleges, that's what we believe in, to that's the strength that we all live with purity and harmony together.
That's a great motto to live by, and you know, I hope everyone in your university and students also follow that and makes it reach to the greater heights. And on let's move on to our last question for that. And you know, you yourself are a very young leader, right? Any suggestions you would like to give to the current youth and aspiring students so that, you know, they are as successful as you are?
Right. So thank you for calling me successful, because I really don't know if I am that right now or not. I'm really trying that I do something for the society in a very positive manner. But the thing that I want to say to all the people listening to this right now is that to have a more happier society and a more live in a more in harmony and in peace, you have to let go of few things. Mm-hmm. And those few things involve I, you know, me, main. Aapko main ka ego chhodna padega. Right? मैंने देखा है कि टू मूव अहेड you can never move ahead if you think that I can do something. You can move ahead if you think that we can do something. I believe this world works in an ecosystem. So everything happens if people respect each other in that ecosystem. To all the young leaders out there, all the entrepreneurs, all the startup builders, all the great job disciplined people, be grounded. Keep your feet on the ground, because you never know what will happen tomorrow, where you will live or not, but it will matter what you leave back for the society. And that will happen when you think for the society, for its betterment, and when you think of we and not I. So that is my lesson to every person out there. It's a very meaningful lesson, which I, at such a young age, have accepted and learned from my guru, my father, Jinnah Sanjeev Agarwal. But I think that he has done so much in his life, and if he is saying that, it truly holds that value, and I am more peaceful when I think this way. So all the young leaders, I know there is so much disappointment and heartbreaks and everything that happens, which really affects one's mentality, and people go to see therapy and all of that, take medications and stuff. These, if you remain true to yourself, live with purity, then I really think that you can be a better leader, a better human being. Thank you.